A former OpenAI employee made predictions in 2021 that have been surprisingly accurate up to 2024 to 2025. He recently made new predictions about the next 5 years of AI, which I believe are important to consider. However, before diving into his latest predictions, we'll first examine some of his 2021 predictions, as they eerily describe the current situation with remarkable precision. Let's take a look at some of Daniel Kukotaslo's predictions. One of the first predictions he made in 2021 is, in 2023, there's going to be insane hype. He said everyone is talking about how these things have common sense understanding, or do they? Lots of bitter think pieces arguing the opposite, and how AI assistants and companions are just around the corner. It's like self-driving cars and drone delivery all over again. You can see right here making a prediction like this, stating that you know the multimodal transformers are now even bigger. The biggest are about half a trillion parameters, costing hundreds of millions of dollars to train and a whole year, and sucking up a significant fraction of the chip output of NVIDIA. This is a remarkable prediction to make in 2021 with such startling accuracy. Predicting the future is particularly challenging in the AI industry because it grows exponentially, and it's difficult for humans to visualize exponential growth. Another prediction he made was about 2024, the year we're currently living in, and looking at this prediction, it's fair to say that it is incredible. So it's clear here that he says that the AI risk community has shorter timelines now, with almost half thinking some sort of point of no return will probably happen by 2030. This is partly due to various arguments percolating around, and partly due to these mega transformers and the uncanny experience of conversing with their chatbot versions. What's astonishing is that making this prediction in 2021, 3 years later in 2024, many people are actually stating that by 2029 or by the end of this decade, we may reach the singularity. This is a really interesting assertion to make in 2021. Of course, it's not a bet, but a speculative blog post. However, it is remarkably accurate. And that's why when we look into the future predictions he's made for the coming years, such as 2026, 2027, and 2028, we should consider them seriously and recognize that there might be some truth to them. Of course, he also says that the community begins a big project to build an AI system that can automate interpretability work. It seems maybe doable and very useful, since poring over neuron visualizations is boring and takes a lot of person hours. Now, what's crazy is that this is exactly what OpenAI is working on. They are actively researching how to automate interpretability research. This research focuses on understanding the inner workings of AI, allowing us to look inside and comprehend the decisions it makes. So let's take a look at some of the predictions he recently made. A few months ago, he shared some new insights. And here's a screenshot of his predictions. I'll leave a link in the description below. One of the recent predictions he's made is about 2024. So he says GPT Next, the next release of GPT, an autonomous agent, is likely to be available by the end of 2024. This model is expected to be a significant improvement over previous versions, with enhanced capabilities in task completion and decision-making. Now, I personally don't think we'll be getting AI agents this year. Of course, there's some nuance to this. It could happen a year later. Either way, a year later is still pretty fast. What's actually interesting about this is that GPT Next is indeed a real development. If we take a look at this graph from a confidential OpenAI presentation, we can see three stages. We had the GPT-3 era, then the GPT-4 era, which we're currently in, and the final stage is something absolutely groundbreaking. Now we're on the verge of entering the GPT-next era. This shift is likely to occur in the later stages of 2024, which is why I keep emphasizing to wait until November or December. There might be a major model release, such as GPT-next, that will demonstrate the true capabilities of these models. Of course, it's not just OpenAI that's driving advancements in AI. Other companies like Google and Meta are also major players in this space and could unexpectedly release models that surpass previous ones. What's interesting is that while I don't think we'll see fully autonomous agents just yet, though I could be wrong, AI breakthroughs can rapidly accelerate development. from what I've seen in interviews and discussions about AI agent development, reliability and scalability remain significant challenges. For example, if you're trying to get agents to perform well on various tasks, the problem is that they need to take reliable actions across many different tasks. Even a small error rate, such as 2%, can accumulate over time, leading to significant inaccuracies. The key point is that improving reliability and scalability is essential for enhancing the performance and accuracy of these models in the long term. We then look at 2025, where they discuss AI becoming widely adopted as autonomous agents. These agents will be capable of performing various tasks, including making purchases. They will understand and execute complex instructions, significantly enhancing productivity and daily life management for users. What's also fascinating is that this development seems to be in the works. During my research on future models, I looked at the trademark office for the GPT-6 trademark. Interestingly, the GPT-6 trademark includes autonomous agents, which implies that GPT-6 is likely to be the product or system that incorporates AI agents. This makes sense considering the trajectory of AI development and the increasing focus on creating more advanced and reliable AI systems. This also aligns with Daniel's prediction of autonomous agents becoming prominent in 2025. Considering that each iteration cycle likely takes around 18 months, and with GPT-5 nearing completion, the next cycle should focus on producing reliable autonomous agents. These agents are expected to completely transform certain parts of the economy. So I think that 2025 is definitely going to be an interesting year. By the end of that year, we might have reliable AI agents capable of performing tasks over long time horizons. I believe Google might be the first to develop these agents, but I wouldn't be surprised if OpenAI gets there too. There are recent developments that I will discuss in upcoming videos, which will show that these companies are much further ahead than you might think. Now, of course, we look at 2026. This is a crazy prediction, but when you actually look at the rest of the predictions, it's not that crazy. The reason I say that is because having a superintelligence AGI, or the emergence of AGI that surpasses human-level performance in most tasks, is only 2 years away. 2 years away from transformational technology seems like such a short time. But as I said before, humans have a poor perception of exponential growth. You can see right here that it says this AGI will be capable of rapid learning and problem solving across diverse domains. It's predicted that within 30 days of deployment, this AGI could rival the expertise of hundreds of human experts. Now, I find this rather fascinating because, as I mentioned before, one of the major predictions I've focused on is the timeline for achieving AGI artificial general intelligence. The specific dates that keep appearing from various credible sources beyond just online speculations are from individuals working at top labs such as OpenAI, Google DeepMind, and Anthropic. These three frontier labs consistently suggest that AGI could emerge between 2027 and at the latest 2030. So 2026 is essentially just 1 year earlier than the earliest prediction, and it's not out of the question that this could potentially happen. Of course, many factors could influence this timeline, such as issues related to scaling or physical limitations on what we're able to achieve. However, with 2 more years of development, especially considering the increased investment and competition, not just from Western companies, but also from China, it will be interesting to see which company manages to reach AGI first. Now we're going to look into 2027, where things start to get even crazier. While 2027 might seem a bit early for achieving artificial superintelligence, ASI, if we consider the possibility of reaching AGI by 2026, then the leap to ASI might not take that long. Achieving ASI after AGI could be relatively quick, because it would essentially involve automating AI research at a vastly accelerated pace, potentially a 100-fold increase. Think of it this way. Currently, we're progressing at human speed, but with AGI, the development could rapidly accelerate beyond our current capabilities. Now, in order to conduct research, there are many tasks humans need to do. For example, a person wakes up, gets to work, drinks their coffee, works for the day, then goes home and engages in other activities. This routine allows for about 6 to 8 hours of deep, focused work. However, with an AGI-level system that operates on par with a human, you could theoretically run it continuously for 24 hours. This would likely triple the output in a single day compared to human researchers. But think of that over the course of a year. Humans can get ill, face unforeseen events, or deal with economic issues, which can disrupt their work. However, an autonomous system capable of continuously advancing AI research with only minimal human oversight could lead to rapid developments. The primary focus of computational resources would likely be on duplicating and enhancing these AI systems. This could result in an exponential acceleration of progress, making it fascinating to see how quickly advancements could occur. For example, it's not just going to be a single smart AI system. Most people don't realize that we'll have millions and millions of copies of this artificial general intelligence, AGI, working towards achieving artificial superintelligence. This kind of exponential increase in AI research output will be absolutely astounding and difficult for us to even comprehend. The combined efforts of these numerous AGI systems will accelerate advancements at a pace previously unimaginable. So you can see right here, it says transition to ASI, rapid advancement in AI capabilities potentially leading to an intelligence explosion. There's a 70% probability of ASI emerging by 2030, and this superintelligence is expected to solve global complex challenges and drive unprecedented technological progress. So it will be fascinating to consider that there's a 70% chance of ASI emerging by 2030. It will be interesting to see how predictions evolve as we approach that final date at the end of the decade. While it might not happen tomorrow or even in 2026, it's certainly a possibility. When it does occur, which I believe it will be a truly transformative time for the economy. Now, what comes after artificial superintelligence? Many people speculate that we'll either face dire consequences or enter a technological utopia. However, one area that's still in its early stages of research and development is nanobots. So nanobots are microscopic robots with a range of applications and use cases that could revolutionize various industries. It's worth noting that they have the potential to significantly impact fields such as medicine, manufacturing, and beyond. If ASI is not achieved, nanobots might emerge as a transformative technology. There's a 30% chance of significant nanobot development by 2027 to 2028, and these microscopic robots could revolutionize medicine, manufacturing, and environmental remediation. Of course, nanobots can literally change environments and humans. It's kind of strange how that sci-fi concept works. But once again, when we look at these AI systems, and if we were to show them to someone from 10 years ago, their mind would be blown. I mean, the first time I saw ChatGPT, I was definitely amazed by what it could do. This might seem crazy until it becomes reality. The logic here is that if we achieve artificial superintelligence, it won't be difficult for it to develop methods to make nanobots commercially and economically viable. If that happens, it will have remarkable implications for society, potentially transforming many aspects of our daily lives and industries. Now, of course, we also have 2029 as the predicted year for humanoid robots. The reason 2029 is significant for humanoid robots is due to the physical challenges they face. The physical world is much harder to master than the digital one because collecting data in the physical world is time-consuming. Currently, we simply don't have enough data to make these robots work well and be truly effective. This lack of data and the complexities of the physical environment are significant hurdles that need to be overcome before humanoid robots can become a common reality. Now, another major issue with humanoid robots is their cost. Some of the humanoid robots available today can cost upwards of $250,000. To make such robots accessible to the average person or even to certain companies, they need to be commercially and economically viable. For people or businesses to justify spending $250,000 on a robot, it must offer significant advantages over human labor, such as extraordinary speed and the ability to work 24 hours on a single charge. Otherwise, it's more practical to use existing industrial robots, like those in factory single-arm robots that perform repetitive tasks efficiently, or the robots used in Amazon's warehouses for picking, packing, and moving boxes. And these types of robots are already cost-effective and well-suited for specific tasks. Now, if these humanoid robots are developed and ASI is achieved, research in all areas, including humanoid robots, is likely to accelerate. This means we could see significant advancements in the embodiment of humanoid robots, surpassing current capabilities. This development could bring us closer to a sci-fi level that many people fear. However, I don't believe this will lead to a scenario where robots cause human extinction. Instead, I think advanced embodiment will become a reality as robotics breakthroughs continue to progress, potentially transforming various aspects of our lives and industries in the future. What's also interesting is that Elon Musk responded to this prediction, stating that Tesla will have genuinely useful humanoid robots in low production within Tesla internally next year, with hopes for high production for other companies by 2026. This indicates a clear trend towards humanoid robots becoming an increasingly significant part of the workforce. These robots have shown effectiveness in specific tasks within factories, but their application is still quite niche and not yet broadly applicable to all industries. However, this progress suggests that we are moving closer to a future where humanoid robots play a more substantial role in various work environments. Now, with the Tesla bot, I do think it's pretty effective. If you've seen the demos, it's incredible how efficiently it moves. However, there are a few limitations regarding its mobility and other factors. While the progress is impressive, there are still challenges to overcome before it can achieve broader applications and greater versatility in various tasks. It's pretty crazy what's going on, and I'm not going to lie, there's a lot coming in the future that you should definitely pay attention to. These technologies are going to impact you in one way or another. If you enjoyed this video, let me know what you think your predictions are. Do you think his predictions are too pessimistic or too optimistic? Let me know your thoughts on these future predictions. Do you believe the future will unfold slower or faster than we expect? I'd love to hear your opinions. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a like, comment down below, and I'll see you all in the next one. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.